Hey guys, welcome to Marcus Loves Movies. My name is Marcus Lee and this is my review of La Belva, aka The Beast, a new action film which has popped up on Netflix. Up front, let me say thanks for checking out this video. If you like movie reviews, discussion and quizzes and all of that good fun movie stuff, please subscribe to the YouTube channel, but let's get into the review. This film popped up on my radar accidentally again on Netflix when you see things floating across the screen saying you should watch this, and I thought, yeah, it looks like it might be my street, so I thought I'll check it out. So The Beast tells a story of a man called Leo Riva, a lonely war veteran who appears to be suffering from PTSD due to his horrific experiences in the army, and whatever decisions he's made along the way means he's now separated from his wife and his children, Mattia and Teresa. One day Teresa is kidnapped and Leo makes it his mission to rescue his daughter, taking no prisoners along the way. Let's be honest, this is an Italian version of Taken. And I like Taken. I like movies like Taken because essentially it's a rescue mission where someone has to save the day or rescue a person, and they have to go against all the odds. They have to ignore what the police say. And there's that air of predictability where you know how certain situations are going to play out. There's a lot of action. There's a lot of gunshots. There's a lot of chase sequences and big fight sequences. You know that characters are going to get shot and stabbed and still manage to get up and keep fighting. So yeah, it's that leave your brain at the door sort of stuff. But what I'll say about this film is that I genuinely enjoyed it. And the reason why I enjoyed this, not just for the and the gunshot stuff, is because I feel like the filmmakers made a genuine attempt to tell a good story with good characters that you genuinely connected with. Like I say, this story has been told in films like Taken, but it's how you tell the story. So the fact is, Leo is a character who's been through some terrible times. Yeah, he's a war veteran. He's seen some horrendous things. And we see flashbacks to, you know, what led him to the present day. And flashbacks in films like this are sometimes a bit cheesy. You know, they have to be done in black and white or sepia to prove that it's a flashback. But they feel very natural and they feel like they actually lend to the story in the current day. Leo as a character is a, you know, he's a big guy, he's unshaven, massive beard, he looks rugged, he looks like he can handle himself in a fight. But the thing that the filmmakers managed to do is make you connect with him. So everything that is on his face, all the pain, all the anguish, all the sadness, all the regret, you see it there. So he's not just this thug who's there to fight. He looks like he could play, you know, background thug number 12 or a bodyguard in any other action film. But this character we really connect with, and I think he does an absolutely fantastic job. So we care about the character's film, which is really good. Cinematography wise, I really liked how it was shot. Nothing groundbreaking, but what we often get with action films is lots of handheld camera work to give a sense of how frantic the situation is. There is a bit of handheld camera work in this from memory, but a lot of it is Steadicam. So there are action sequences where we get long unbroken takes where we get to see all aspects of what is happening. So we really feel like we're in the scene because there's no cutaways. You can't get away with it. You have to see everything. And you feel like the main actor really is involved in all of those fight scenes, often with fast cuts. You know, that's an excuse for the stunt double to go in there and do all the scary stuff. But we feel like Leo, the actor playing Leo, is really involved in everything. I mean, Taken 2 is guilty of that. There's Liam Neeson movie, but there's a lot of quick cuts. And, you know, you kind of do that to mask when you need the stunt double to get in there. So that's really good. And there's other stuff where, you know, yeah, it's dark in places and it's very bloody. I'll say that it's very gory, so yeah, there's a lot of blood. So if you hate blood, don't watch it. But it's an action film and it's a violent action film and it's got a certificate on it. So, you know, you should be aware of that. But really good. There's a Mexican standoff thing in there, which is like not very believable. How many people, by the way, does it take to have a Mexican standoff? Because there was a Mexican standoff with a lot of people. I won't say that because I don't want to spoil anything. But yeah, there's lots of things that don't always make sense, but the filmmakers have done their best. The police are rubbish in this. The police are useless, but I think the police are always useless in action films like this. So yeah, I think you should watch it. And like I've said in past reviews, some people don't like foreign cinema, and foreign cinema is, it's in a language that's foreign to your native language. So, you know, if you're an English speaker, then you think I'm not watching it an Italian film. But gosh, I'm just seeing there are so many great little gems like this that, you know, if I decided not to watch it because it's subtitled, I'd miss out on a great piece of entertainment. I think this is a really decent film. It's not the greatest film ever. And I was going to give this film 3 stars, but I'm going to give it a little bit more because I feel like the filmmakers made a genuine attempt to tell a good story. And when the film finishes, you've enjoyed it. The characters are believable. The story was genuine. It doesn't feel like cannon fodder, like something you're just going to forget easily. It was a good film. So my official Marcus Loves Movies rating for La Belva, aka The Beast, is 3.5 stars. Special shout out to the filmmakers because these are the people that make it happen. So the film is directed by Ludovico Di Martino and it stars Fabrizio Gifuni and Lino Musella. Sorry if I butchered those names, but I've seen pictures of Fabrizio Gifuni in other things and he looks completely different. So clearly a really good character actor. As always, I'm interested to find out what you think of this film, La Belva, if you've already seen it. If you have already seen it, would you highly recommend The Beast or do you think it was quite poor, to say the least? Did you think this film was a mighty stallion or did you not bother because it was Italian? Please leave a comment on this video, give it a like, and like I say, if you like your movie stuff, quizzes, reviews, discussions, and all of that good stuff, please consider subscribing to the channel and hit the notification bell so you're notified every time I release a new video. Thank you for watching this review. I hope to engage with you again soon. Until then, take care of yourselves. I'm out. Peace.